Merhaba, ben İrem Şentürk. Homeopati İstanbul'un konuğu olarak yanımızda bulunan Doktor Yogesh Segalli, homeopati üzerine küçük bir söyleşi yapacağız. Kendisi Yeni Delhi'de yaşayan bir homeopat doktor. Hem tedavi uyguluyor hem bütün dünyayı gezerek Segalli metodunu homeopatlara tanıtıyor, öğretiyor.
Thank you for inviting me for to have this interview with you. So what would you like to know about?
First of all, we would like to listen from you. What is homeopathy? Where is it originated?
Okay, so homeopathy was founded in 18th century by Dr. Samuel Hahnemann. And homeopathy is considered as a holistic approach. Means that it can deal with all kinds of problems, acute, chronic, related to emotional, all kinds of issues which can be covered by one medicine. Homeopathy is known as a science as well as an art. We can say homeopathy as a science because we prove our medicine on the healthy human being. And we can say it as an art because it works under certain rules, like law of simile.
And why did you choose to become a homeopath?
Homeopathy has come to me from my father, who has started practicing homeopathy in 1970. And I got inspired by the way he was working on his patient. And I saw the result. People are getting better by many chronic diseases, acute diseases. So it has inspired me to be a homeopath. I could study medicine, but I prefer to study homeopathy.
And what are the basic principles of Segalli method? What is the difference from classical homeopathy?
The basic principle is that first of all, what is classical homeopathy? Classical homeopathy is not a part of homeopathy. We have only homeopathy, number one. Classical homeopathy is a certificate course which is given to a German homeopath by an association. So they had no idea what to say to the certificate, so they gave it a classical homeopathy name to it. So classical homeopathy is not coming as a different part of homeopathy. So first we have homeopathy, and under homeopathy we have people who are doing homeopathy, like taking the modalities, generalities, miasm, all this kind of things. And in Segalli method we are using basically emotional part of the patient.
So we heard that homeopathy is an alternative therapy, and you don't get any side effects, and it works slow. What do you say about it?
Yes, it is propagated as an alternative medicine part, but we don't agree to it. I especially, like me, many homeopaths from India, we believe that it is not an alternative medicine, it is a complete science. And it has a power to treat the people as a whole. And the idea of homeopathy is it is a notion that, for example, homeopathy is slow or homeopathy has no side effects. It has come because the basic idea of Dr. Hahnemann to bring homeopathy is that he wanted to bring a medicine which should not have a side effect on the person, and on the other side it has a power to heal the person as a whole. And why it has no side effect? Because first the medicine are proved on the healthy human being, so we know about its side effects or whatever effects are there beforehand. So we are very particular For example, if I have to give a patient a pulsatile medicine, we know already that at what time and what are the factors which are responsible if we give this medicine to a patient, what is going to happen to him. So because it's already proved on the healthy human being, so we prevent these things to happen. Mm-hmm. So that's why it has no side effects.
And do you give single remedies or combining remedies together?
See, the basic principle of homeopathy is to give one remedy at a time and in small doses. They are the two basic principles, I can say. We are working on the principle of similimum. So it is all homeopath should believe that there is only one similimum for a person. It means that if I find one remedy for a patient, that remedy is only belongs to him. So I cannot say that there are three or four similimum for a person. It is wrong, completely wrong. So if somebody has to practice homeopathy, he should know that he has to find a remedy, one remedy for a person that has to be also similimum. And then after we find the remedy, the doses has to be small. We are not going to repeat the doses of the medicine every day like antibiotics. In homeopathy, so that is why homeopathy is a law simplex. Law simplex means to be given in a simple way, in a small amount of medicine. So our principle is less quantity, more quality.
And is that similimum valid for whole life or does it change?
If you have really found a similimum, till the person is sick from one problem, for example, a patient has been suffering from asthma, we found a similimum for him. And until the asthma doesn't get better, the similimum remains the same. After the asthma gets better, if that similimum is over, that part is over. Maybe after 10 years or 15 years, he suffers from some other problem, which is not related to asthma, maybe the similimum is same or different. It depends upon the situation or emotional level that time.
And as far as we know, there are several ways to find the similimum. So what makes Zegal method different than the other methods to find similimum?
In 1970s, when Dr. Zegal started learning homeopathy and then later practicing homeopathy, he found that yes, there are ways, like we have ways of finding a remedy by collecting the symptom, whole symptom of the patient from his physical level, mental level, traumatic level, for example some trauma, emotions in the life, whatever happened to the patient in his life, past history, his family history from the when he born, something happened that time, and then how the disease developed in him. So it actually takes one hour to 2 hours to collect all the information from the patient. And then it could be that patient is not too familiar or has no idea what actually happened in the past, for example. So it was become a tedious job for a homeopath to collect all this information and to find a remedy similimum on that basis. So in 1970s, Dr. Zegal has found that if we work on the emotional level of a patient only and select the similimum on the basis of the mental state of the patient, it actually does the same job of collecting all the information. It's not that he wanted to exclude all the information, but he thought that by one information we reach to the same point where we are collecting actually the 1 hour information. So if we know the mental state of a patient in 10 minutes, it is actually the same work we do in 1 hour by collecting all the information. So by this means, Dr. Zegal thought that it should be very not so difficult task for a homeopath to first collect the symptom of the patient, so then that time limit, the time gap has got reduced. Then it's like more accurate, because a person knows about his emotions much better than his family history or past history or what happened to the mother or the family. In this way, Dr. Sehgal thought that to find a remedy on the mind is more easy, simple and accurate form.
What happens after you give the remedy? How do you manage the patient?
Okay, homeopathy is divided. I can divide into the parts. First part is when the patient comes, we have to collect the whatever information he wants to give regarding the problem. Now here people are divided. For example, some they are taking the they want to note that which kind of miasm he is, which kind of kingdom he is. For example, we have plant kingdom, animal kingdom and mineral kingdom. So some try to understand the patient belongs to which kingdom. Some physicians they try to find which miasm. On some patient, some doctor they want to see what modalities he has. So everybody gives importance to whatever they have art in them. Mm-hmm. And if we give medicine, I can say about myself, when I give medicine by emotions, by mind, what we see that after we reach to the conclusion that these are the emotions of the patient who are very present, predominating and persisting, and after collecting this, working on these three P's, we find the remedy. And this remedy, the first part is to collect present, predominating and persisting according to Dr. Sehgal method. After that, when we give the remedy, we believe that the remedy, if what the role of simlimimum is to work on the system of the patient, not on the symptoms. So the system has become activated. So the first part of the homeopathic medicine as a whole is to activate the system. When the system becomes activated, it activates the defense mechanism of the body, and when the defense mechanism gets alert or becomes activated, it repels the problem. It helps the body to repel the problem out. Mm-hmm. This is our way of homeopathy works.
So in this way you understand, you found the simlimimum.
Yeah, if the simlimimum is right, the first thing is that it will bring the defense mechanism into the activation mode. And before that, the patient, there are three things like appetite, sleep, and stool and urine. These parts become better. The first thing is if the patient says that, oh doctor, after I took the medicine, in half an hour I start feeling that I must eat something. And then after that I slept for a few hours. And after that I pass my urine and stool in a regular mode. It is the first sign that you are going towards healthy. So basic idea of homeopathy is to bring the patient from the sick state to the healthy state, then to the cure, finally. So what the simlimimum does is, simlimimum makes or activates the healing process. Once the healing process starts, then the body repels the problem, whatever problem body has, as a disease, or you can say sickness, or mental derangement, any kind of problem, the body repels the problem itself from the system.
Can we guess how long it will take the cure?
See, the cure can be a long process, but the first part is the health part. Mm-hmm. First, the body has to be healthy. If body is not healthy, the cure is not going to take place. Okay. I cannot make a sick factory to produce something. A sick factory cannot produce something until unless it becomes healthy first, it has economy, it has labor, it has people who are working, then something will be produced. In the same way, the body is, when the body is sick, you cannot say the cure will come automatically. For cure, the healing process must start. And healing process starts, for example, from 5 minutes to half an hour. healing process start. It means like it's like a pushing a button, activate. Now the activate, the patient says, okay, after the medicine, in half an hour, I started feeling well-being. So the well-being starts comes first, and then the process of cure starts. It could be depending upon the acuteness of the problem or chronicity of the problem. If it is an acute problem, for example, fever, for example, influenza, for example, diarrhea, for example, an acute infection, it can be solved in the minimum time without harming the, without compromising with the health of the patient. It should be that remedy should not torture. It should not be torture process. Healing process is not a torture process. Healing process is to help whatever is happening in the body to come out automatically. So for example, if somebody has a fever, we cannot expect that the fever should go in 1 month or 3 weeks or 2 weeks. Or if somebody has a diarrhea, we don't expect that after the medicine, if he is passing 5 stools, then after the medicine he is going to pass 20 stools, or it will take 3 weeks for him to clear the stomach. No, this is wrong. If something is happened acute, it has to be go in the same format. Acute has to be taken care first. It's like a crisis. So crisis has to go first immediately. So if there is a fever, so it depends upon also which kind of fever he has, malaria, typhoid. Accordingly, the patient feels better by homeopathy, and with the time it goes away. And in case of chronic problems, when there are chronic problems are there, it depends, for example, a patient has a hypertension, diabetes, or rheumatic arthritis, or asthmatic problem for many, many years. In this issue also, the homeopathy medicine, the first part of the homeopathy is to slow down the process, like first let to slow down the progress of the disease. So the first is to check the disease. So the disease should not now progress further. The first process, it is very quick. For example, after a week, patient says, ah, my problem was increasing every week, every day, but after your medicine, the progress stopped. Then process of healing starts. Then the patient says, okay, I feel now little my problem is going down. For example, my hypertension, for example, in 1 year, he says, now my BP is getting stable. I can leave my medications now, slowly we withdraw the medicines. So in the process, you see that 2 to 3 years, normally it takes for any problem to get better if it is of chronic issues.
I also heard that there are some different approaches by practicing homeopathy, like clinical homeopathy, complex homeopathy, or even injection of homeopathic drugs. What are these methods?
Okay, if you say, to be honest, I only do pure homeopathy. It means I'm not mixing all the medicines, but I, for example, as I told you, as a basic law, we should give one medicine at a time, simplex doses, not repeating the medicines. We should find the medicine which can be or like, for example, after finding the medicine, we must find also a potency according to the vital force of the body. These are the correct way of doing homeopathy. But nowadays, as you are right, that I've also heard there are some doctors who are practicing like a therapeutic way. Means if there is a pain in the knee joint, if there is a heart problem, if there is a problem in the eye, if there is a sinus problem, then they want to find a remedy particularly for the sinus, particularly for hypertension, but they are ignoring the law of homeopathy. They are not, maybe you can say they are lethargic, or they are ignorant about the whole homeopathy. They don't study very well, or they are impatient, or they have no time to find a simlimum. So they are opting for therapeutic way of finding a remedy, which in my way is totally wrong. And nobody should practice like this. And then we have also heard that there are some complex people are giving up and making it's like a tonsillate, cough aid, diabetic aid, like these medicines are also very popular now in the market. It is harmful. And if you say why they are harmful, because they are also homeopathy and they are also medicine. So I say that it is harmful then, because we are now it is like homeopathic medicine in an allopathic way. So it's, we should not, already this principle of homeopathy has come because we are, Dr. Honeyman was aghast, or he was totally painful by the way allopathic medicine was given that time, many medicine at a time, like a person is taking 5 remedies in one day. So to curb that thing, homeopathy has come, and now some of us from doctor in homeopathy has gone back to the same idea, to give many large doses to make the patient happy, but they are not looking for their benefit. They are instead of giving betterment, they are pushing the patient into a wrong direction.
Do one get positive results with combining remedies or clinical approaches?
See, results and cure, they are the two different aspects. Mm-hmm. Result anything can give. Even if you drink water, for example, 2 liters of water every day, it can also show you the result. So result is not ultimately cure. If I follow the principle of homeopathy that we have to cure everybody, then this kind of methods, like complex method, giving too many medicine at a time, or complex disease, or mixing with vitamins, with mixing with something, is not the main mission for them. The main mission for them is in a commercial aspect, to just make a patient better anyhow. But this is not we are going to achieve by homeopathy. So I must say that those who are doing it, kindly don't do such a practice. Please follow the law of homeopathy as given to us by our master Dr. Honeyman, and follow the basic principles that it should not be. Please give follow that it should be, we should find a simplicium and only one remedy at a time. If you are failed, then you have a right to find a second remedy, because when one simplicium you could not find a simplicium, then you can find another simplicium, or you try to find simplicium after changing the medicine. But not that you can, if you are not sure about, for example, you have reached to 5 remedies and you are not sure which is the simplicium of the patient. So instead of that, you work little harder, you tend to give all the 5 remedies to the patient. Then who will work? Okay, something will happen to the patient. And I think this is a very wrong practice. It should be stopped and it should not be encouraged.
So what do you think about the future of homeopathy?
That's a very good, brilliant question, I think. It is changing. Or I can say that I have been traveling nearly many countries as a teacher, or I'm meeting homeopaths. In some countries, homeopathy is now legally allowed, but it has to be done by allopaths. That is the one criteria now. In India, like when the criteria is, first you have to finish your high school with chemistry, biology, physics, and in a good marks, then you have to go for an entrance exam. After you clear this entrance exam with a very high marks, then you get admission in homeopathic college, and there you study 5.5 years with theory and clinical experiences. You have 1 year internship, and this college, our student must go 5 days a week for at least 8 hours study every day, and then 1 year of clinical training. Then you complete this course, and after that also there is a possibility to do 2 years MD in homeopathy, or postgraduate course in homeopathy in India. So if I talk about India, so the future is very good. We have now 300,000 doctors, 200 homeopathic medical colleges and hospitals. Every city has at least 100 dispensaries supported by the government. So people are using homeopathy in a large number in India. And the government gives us a special courses. So these courses are legalized and are under the university. So the future is bright. I don't see that homeopathy is in danger but homeopathy could be in danger if homeopath does not improve their way of practicing homeopathy.
Thank you very much for your nice conversation. We will continue our talks in future and also your seminars in Turkey.
Thank you very much to also to Homeopathy Istanbul, and I'm looking forward to visit to Istanbul or another part of to propagate homeopathy should be done in a proper way.
Homeopathy İstanbul olarak Dr. Yogesh Segal'e çok teşekkür ediyoruz. Kendisini düzenlediğimiz eğitimlerde aramızda görmeye devam edeceğiz. Hoşçakalın.